Highlander, hear me out. I hear there's a group of Tanakh holed up near Stone's Echo. No one knows why they're there. One of our veterans wants to seek them out, learn what they're doing out here.
Tanakh, the new Taru territory. That doesn't sound good. What's going on here?
You're the one who spoke before the chorus. Maybe you can help.
This is not your concern, Outlander. Have we not tolerated enough of your intrusions?
I think you can handle one more. What is it?
My wife, Kalai. She was to join the chorus. She went up to the promontory to perform the rite of discovery, but she must have fallen. And now they are abandoning the search.
We have done enough, Bree. The search party found nothing but her instrument broken beside the riverbed.
And atop the promontory was only the dye she used for the ritual. We will not ask more of our people to risk their lives because of one woman's stubbornness.
But the seed she carried deserved to be planted and remembered. I heard how you helped the land god, Ray. How you saw what no one else could. Please, will you look for her seed pouch?
False hope is a creeping vine.
How was Kalai chosen to join the chorus?
The chorus chooses its own, but they can't do so in isolation. They must listen to the people. Kalai was a growing voice for new ideas instead of old traditions, and her beliefs were catching on.
We cannot deafen ourselves to dissonance, unpleasant though it might be.
So you had to admit Kalai, or risk legitimizing her ideas even more.
The Outlander catches on quick.
The Rite of Discovery. What is it exactly?
It's a pilgrimage to the Promontory. The place where the first Utaro beheld Plainsong. Kalai was to follow the path our ancestors took. Mark her eyes with dye and then play her song while overlooking the land. She then would have added her mark on the Promontory itself, joining the marks of those who came before. Every new chorus member used to make the journey. But because of the derangement, the practice has been abandoned. Too dangerous. No one's done it for years.
Then why did she do it?
We all urged her not to. But, as was her way, she ignored our warnings.
She thought it would lend strength to her point of view. She needed to prove that she respected the old ways, even as she advocated against them. Then maybe more people would listen.
What were Kalai's political beliefs?
Radical. You would have gotten along.
Plainsong is dying. But Kalai believed we don't have to die with it. As the wind carries the seed to distant lands. She proposed that the Utaro leave Plainsong and seek out a new home.
We are bound to this land. A tree cannot pick up its roots, even as fire approaches.
But you're not trees.
It doesn't matter now.
Kalai was carrying a pouch of seeds?
Every Utaro keeps one. We choose the seeds at a young age, taken from the plants of our forebears or those of other significance. And when one passes, their seeds are returned to the land that nourished them, so that life may spring again. Which is why I want Kalai's pouch. Her seeds deserve to be planted in Plainsong.
The river will carry the seeds to new soil, where they will take root and flower.
But they won't be at home.
It's the best we can hope for.
If I'm out that way, I can take a look around.
Thank you. The promontory is northeast of here. Look for the broken bridge at the bottom of the cliffs, right at the promontory's base. That's where the search party found her instrument.
Okay. That all right with you?
How you waste your time is not my concern.
Searching for what the land has already reclaimed is fruitless.
Yes?
I need to be going.
Please, let me know if you find Kalai's seed pouch.
We'll have nothing by month's end.
I understand your concern.
Your understanding won't keep us from starting.
The child, Dre, was bold and strong, and her mind was full of questions.
Will
often
you trade
she
today?
Went to the old woman, longest serving in the chorus, who would look up from her tea and smile. Today, Dre asked, where does the world begin?
And since you refused to send out more hunters...
It is too dangerous out there, Yul. Did you see Ven's injuries?
No answer of mine will satisfy you.
May the wind carry
you. So you must go out in the world and search.
What's going on here? Sounds like there's a problem.
We're speaking about something important, Outlander.
Yul, please. Later.
A reminder of why I often prefer plants to people. They're so much less demanding. I apologize for Yul. My people used to be friendlier, but hunger robs many of their kindness.
Seems like there's a lot around here in short supply. Is there anything that can help?
As Yul said, we need food. So much so that we've sent hunting parties to the Old Growth, a forest in the north. We never used to hunt animals for food. We never had to. But as our crops fail, we've run out of options.
But something else went wrong.
A machine slaughtered the last hunting party we sent out. A Clostrider. But to hear the lone survivor tell it, more deadly than any we've seen before. Until it's gone, I can't risk more hunters, but without that meat, our people grow more lean every day.
I saw you up there when I spoke in front of the chorus.
Yes. I'm sorry I couldn't do more to help you, and especially Zoe. Many Utaru like to think we're above politics, but that is far from true. I don't often agree with Fane, but I have to work closely with him on many matters.
So you didn't want to cross him?
Not in such a public way, no. I hope you don't hold it against me.
What's done is done. It all turned out in the end. Without more food, how much longer can the tribe hold out?
The land gods blight the fields more every day. A month? Maybe two? The maddening part is that many are resigned to this fate. Like Fane, who would have us simply wait to die. You heard him. Death is merely part of the grand cycle.
But you'd rather do something.
Yes, like send hunters to the Old Growth for food. Fane fought that idea too. He will undoubtedly cast what happened to the hunting party as another reason to side with him.
If we let him. Tell me everything you know about the machine that attacked your hunters.
It fell upon them near the edge of the Old Growth. One of them, Ven, survived and made it back to Plainsong. If you wish to question him, he's recovering with our healers. The other four hunters weren't so fortunate. It must be a powerful beast. Can you destroy it?
I've handled tough ones before.
Good. The Old Growth must be made safe for hunting. One more thing. Every Utaru wears a small patch of seeds. Given at birth, planted at death. It is how we remember our loved ones and celebrate their place in the cycle. It would mean a great deal to the hunters' families if you could recover them.
I'll do what I can.
I know you will. Be careful in the forest.
Before I head for the Old Growth, I might want to talk to the survivor. See what he can tell me about the Clostrider.
May the land bloom in your steps.
Please, come back again.
There's the survivor from the hunting party.
It's a brighter day with you among us.
Would you spare a moment?
Aloy, wasn't sure you'd ever come around. What do you think of Plainsong?
It's quite a place.
Sure. As long as you like the smell of manure. Don't mind me. I won't go wandering again, I promise. There are people who need me here. Some of the others the Eclipse took had it worse than me. A lot worse.
Do what you can for them, Yef.
I will. Won't be anything like you did, but I'll give it my best.
That's one of my favorite recipes.
Happy to share.
Hear about the machine in the old growth.
You're going after that horror.
I'm going to try. Do you mind answering a couple of questions about it?
I'll tell you what I can.
Tell me what happened, step by step.
There were five of us, hunting for boar to help feed the tribe, just like we had done half a dozen times before. Some machines got in our way. Happens every time we go to the old growth. Like always, we cleared them out. But this time, when we were done, we heard this roar.
Hey, easy.
I saw a flash from the trees, all claws and tail. It ripped right through Cole and Rhee, and Zan came right at me, slashed my shoulder. There was blood. Then an arrow slammed into its neck. My friend Lau, he distracted it, yelled and whooped. It turned on him. He disappeared into the trees, and it followed him. Last thing I heard him yell was for me to run. So I did. I was halfway back to Plainsong before I realized what I had done. Left Lau to die.
Is there anything you can tell me about the machine that might help?
It looked like a claw strider, but it was stronger. Much stronger.
Anything else?
Its armor was darker, and it had a strange purple glow.
Thanks. I think I know what I'm dealing with. I need to get going.
You don't want to fight that thing.
Trust me. I know what I'm doing.
Well, if you do, I hope you cut it to shreds. It killed Lau. My oldest friend. What else do you need?
I need to head out.
All right.
Up the strike later.
Good hunting, Outlander.
This must be the old growth. Shill said the hunting party was attacked near here. Best place to start looking for the hunter's seed pouches. Use of this. There's a dead Otaru in the clearing. Must be one of the hunters. I'll take out these machines before I can grab the seed pouch. This green shine off carefully. exciting. Got the pouch, but where are the other hunters? And the Clawstrider that attacked them. I better check for tracks with my focus. There. Clawstrider tracks. I might have chased the other hunters deeper into the forest. Got the seed pouch. Better pick up the Clawstrider's tracks and keep going. The third hunter. I should collect their seed pouch. He died where the Clawstrider caught him. At least I can return his seed pouch.
I need to put a stop to that machine.
I better scan for tracks. Three hunters. There should be one more. Clawstrider probably chased after him. From the Clawstrider. Maybe from a weapon? Looks like the Clawstrider continued up the cliff. Wow, gave it quite the chase. Cliff's covered in gouge marks. The machine must have clawed its way up. Looks like the machine's claw got stuck here. Slowed it down. And the hunter kept running. Take this to a dire later. Close to his tracks in here. And no sign of the last hunter either. I don't believe that those machines are watching that crack in the cliff. Better clear them out first. could break off its tail, stop one of its attacks. Frost would do a lot of damage.
Thank you.
machines were interested in that crevice in the cliff. I should check it out. I had a feeling Lao was pretty resourceful.
Gone? I wasn't expecting a rescue. Thank you, Outlander.
I'm after the Claw Strider. Where did it go?
You're hunting it?
It's okay. I fought bigger.
Who are you?
Just stay here while I try to pick up its trail. I'll let you know when it's... I can handle it from here.
Slow it down for you.
Stay back, and don't fire until I do.
Watch for its claws.
The killer is more powerful than a normal machine.
Now!
I've got your back!
It's done.
We did it!
Be careful not to let this stain my hands. Lao, right? Ben thinks he left you for dead.
He made it back. I was worried about him.
He said you saved him by getting the Claw Strider to chase you.
And he saved me by sending you after me, so we're even. I can't wait to see the look on his face when he figures out I'm alive.
Go on back then. And thanks for the assist. Slowing that machine down helped.
And here, take this. I can craft another one if I need it, but... well, I hope I won't after this, not for a while.
One more hunter gets to go home. Now I just have to return the seed pouches to Shale. Better leave it alone for now. This will make a good die. I don't think I can override you. Guess there are more cauldrons out there. This will be over quick with frost ammo. Don't have to worry about its tail if I shoot it off. For Kalai's seal patch. I better start at the bridge. Footprints. Must be from the search party. Bree said this is where they found his wife's instrument. The search party concluded Kalai's body was probably carried away by the river. But from up there, that old tree would have caught her. I don't think she actually fell. I should check up at the promontory. Maybe the search party missed something. It looks like the search party took the trail under the stone arch. That must be the way up to the promontory. To the promontory that way. I should see where the other trail leads, back by the broken bridge. Is this easy? Debris. There must have been another path up. Guess Kalai and the search party climbed the cliff instead. This broke off some time ago. Why do I get the feeling this isn't going to be an easy trail to follow? Utaru Trailhead. Looks like this is where the Rite of Discovery started. Debris on the trail. Oh, It looks like pieces of a bridge. Looks like this fell down here a long time ago. Maybe from a storm. One of the trails broken away. Kalai must have climbed her way up too. I made it to the top. She must have been a good climber. It doesn't add up that she fell. This must be the promontory. Looks like Kalai was doing something at that stone table. I should take a look. Into a dye. Kalai must have done this as part of her ritual. I should look around. My focus will help me figure out what happened to her. It was plain song, just like the first Utaru saw it. Close to figuring out what happened to Kalai. And I have a feeling the answers are on the promontory. I still need to look around up here. Figure out what happened to Kalai. The search party was up here, all right? There's too many tracks to pick out Kalai's. Looks like the edge broke off recently. I still don't think she could have fallen into the river from here. I should keep looking around. These flowers have a trace of something on their petals. The dye Kalai was wearing. Looks like it left a trail. Too faint for the search party to have noticed, but my focus can pick it up. There's the dye trail. Looks like it leads away from the cliff edge. Dye trail ends here, with a lot of broken branches. I should take a closer look. Branches were snapped off recently. From some kind of struggle? And over here, drag marks. Looks like they lead through this thicket. I can follow them with my focus. Two bodies? One must be Kalai, but who's the other woman? Kalai.
those marks on her neck. She was strangled. At least I can return her seed pouch to Bree. So the killer must have tried to push Kalai off the cliff. That's why the search party found her instrument by the river. But Kalai fought back. So the killer strangled her. And then dragged her here.
It's over just yet.
Thank you.
Okay. I better grab the killer's seed pouch. Might help identify her. Look at that. Maybe Fane and Cal back in Plainsong will know who the seed pouch belongs to. This might have been the way the first Utaru climbed down the mountain. Looks like most of the path is crumbled away. Scattered. The signal seems to be coming from behind those vines. Some kind of drone. Is it watching over this area? Might have some useful data, but how to get up there? Shoot it down.
Taking you with me. Got it.
Data.
Shadows come in from up there. I can't see a way to climb. There's no way to reach it right now. Filling up the canisters on the press.
Lament Kalir's death, but perhaps it's time to move on.
No, not until I hear from Aloy.
There's Shale. I should give her the seed pouches I recovered
from
the old growth.
And garments for sale.
A word, Aloy. Aloy, Lao has come back to us thanks to you. Is it safe to send out another hunting party? It's never going to be completely safe out there, but the Clostrider is dead. Here, the seed pouches. I'll see that these are returned to their families for planting and remembrance. I'm sure Lao and Van would like to thank you in person. You can find them at the Grove. It's been an honor, Aloy. May the land be kind to you.
Do you really think an outlander can find what our own people could not?
She saw what ailed Landgod Rey, didn't she? Maybe she'll see something that leads to Khaleesi Project.
Temper your expectations, Bree.
That will protect and impress.
That's Goliath. You found it.
Bree. Goliath didn't fall. She was murdered.
What?
I went up to the promontory. I found Kalai and the body of the woman who killed her.
That's impossible. The search party already checked up there. There was nothing.
The bodies were in a separate clearing. Away from where the search party checked. A stalker had mauled her while she was trying to hide Kalai's body.
Who was she?
I was hoping you would know. I brought back her seed pouch.
It belongs to Lina. Kel's apprentice. I don't understand. Why would she do this?
Maybe we should ask Kel.
But she... You, there. Where is Kel?
I saw her leave out the east gate about an hour ago.
She's going home. Summerwind.
She's running away? She needs to stand trial.
I can catch her. Where is this place?
Look for a ruined settlement at our southern border. It's her childhood home. We will get the guards and try to catch up with you.
Machines are quick!
Summer wind. But where is Kel?
Hey,
got you.
So now everyone knows. It was only a matter of time once you went up that cliff.
You stood right next to the man whose wife you had murdered and told him to move on.
I never wanted any of this to happen.
Then why?
Calais sowed the seeds of discord. She wanted the Utaru to leave Plainsong, abandon our home. If that thought caught on, it would have been more destructive than any sickness or machine.
So you had her killed?
There is a natural order to all things. Growth, decay, death. It's the way of the world. A tree cannot pick up its roots, so I stopped what was threatening us. I'm sorry it came to it, but it's over now.
I'm gonna make sure you pay for all the suffering you've caused.
Too late.
Two people dead. At least you're paying with your life.
My choice.
All of this was your choice.
No! She needed to stand trial! Calais deserves justice!
She's dead, Bree. That's justice enough.
It isn't much, but I want you to have this. As thanks. I won't have to spend the rest of my days wondering what happened to Calais.
Blighted are the leaves. Three of our people, dead. And for what? I admit it. I never wanted you among us. But now, it seems I must thank you for revealing the rot that had taken hold here.
I'm sorry it had to happen this way.
At least with the rot removed, new growth can thrive.
I'll plant Calais' seed pouch in Plainsong. You made that possible.
I'll make sure Kel's body is properly sealed.
Kel would have gotten away with murder, if not for you, Aloy.
Kel's treachery will be a shock to many in Plainsong. You've done enough for us, Outlander. Go while the roots are strong. I'll make sure Kel's body properly seen to. Kel's treachery will be a shock.
I'll always be grateful you exposed Kel's treachery. I'll plant Calais' seed pouch in Plainsong. You made that possible.
filming half of these later.
Did you know there's a tunnel southwest of here that leads to the Tanakh Desert? Last expedition to go through was Porgup's, but I haven't heard a word from them since.
That can't be good. I'll look for them if I'm out that way.
All right.
Good to have extra.
There are people in need. I could use your help.
What do you need?
A squad of Tanakh is holed up in the cave to the south. I think they're in trouble. At least one of them is injured. I'm headed there to offer help. But with the Tanakh, such an offer might be perceived as an insult, even when help is needed. Will you come with me? I saw you speak before the chorus, so I know you can be persuasive. And if things get out of hand, I will be stronger with your spear at my side.
Isn't there someone in Plainsong who can go with you?
Not with Tanakh rebels prowling our borders. No one wants to get involved.
I'll do what I can.
Good. I'm headed to their camp now. Please, follow.
Why are you willing to help these Tanakhs if other Utaru won't?
I've dealt with the Tanakh before.
I don't really think they'll take an offer of help as an insult?
Tanakh are by nature unpredictable. Anything is possible.
Well, don't have to worry about running out.
Almost there. The squad is camped inside.
You there! This camp belongs to Eagle Squad. Retreat or die.
At ease, Eagle. I'm not here for blood. Just to parley.
You know the parley sign?
Let us in so we can talk.
So far, so good.
Long way from the desert, aren't we? This one was blinded?
Boy, nothing gets by you.
Looks like your training mission didn't go according to plan. We're here to help, if you want it.
How does an Utaro know we're on a training mission?
He knew how to request a parley, too.
He's not Utaru. Or Tenakth. He must be a veteran.
A veteran?
I didn't think there were any left.
We don't need help from a washed-out farmer.
Could have fooled me, judging by the look of things.
Sister, it sounds like they just want to help us. Why not let them?
What do we got to lose?
You said you're on a training mission?
A machine hunt. The final test before a young squad goes on active duty.
Everything was going fine. We tracked a claw strider and hit it hard,
but it fled into a herd of bristlebacks.
One charged right at Kore. He dodged just in time and landed a strike as it passed.
I hit an acid canister. The spray was like fire in my eyes.
A terrible wound.
I should have scouted ahead, spotted the herd.
No, I should have spotted that canister.
What does it mean to be a veteran?
I was born to Nacht, but offered to Utaru in exchange for tribute.
Tribute?
Back when there was plenty, the Utaru offered yearly gifts of food to the Tenakth to keep peace between them. Over time, this tribute grew into an exchange of people. The Tenakth needed able-bodied youth to fight their clan battles. And the Utaru needed veteran soldiers to train the defenders of Plainsong. I was just such a soldier.
Was being the key word.
You may yet need my spear, young warrior.
What do you need?
Supplies.
Dried meat, ammunition, weapons, camping equipment.
A lot of provisions for a trip back to the desert.
Everything we need is at Riverwatch. A huge cache of war spoils up there, left over from the route.
The route?
When our forces drove the Karja back to Barren Light, they made sure the Kestrels felt the loss, made it hurt.
Marshal Kinnera shot a score of fleeing Karja from the top of Riverwatch, and her squad gathered the loot. It's all just sitting up there. Ours for the taking.
Deadly machines are known to patrol that place, and the ruin itself is on the brink of collapse.
You think machines and rotting ruins are enough to keep out Eagle Squad?
No, but your injuries are. Let Jax and I grab these supplies for you.
This is our mission. I'm not handing it over to some...
Fine. Come with us.
Fine. The three of you, hold position. I'll be back.
Be safe, sister. Sakura, is she all right?
The ruin is this way. Once we get those supplies, everything will be fine.
So you say.
What's that supposed to mean?
Your brother's condition is...
That's not your problem, farmer.
So you say.
Stop saying that.
Hey, calm down. We're trying to help, remember?
So you say.
We'll have to cut across the river. Avoid the Outlander camp down the road.
Trespassers.
There are strangers in these lands.
Edible.
Just like you, Eagle.
Once you're cooked.
Ugh!
Something wrong?
I hate getting wet.
Tough as a ravager, this one.
I heard that. We're here.
The entrance should be right under that arch.
Shock ammo.
Not happy to see me? That's the last of them.
I had that.
Give credit where credit is due, young one.
Maybe I would have handled it better if I wasn't busy covering you, old man.
Aren't I lucky?
You know, if this is too much for your old bones, you can always head back.
You should be more worried about that left arm than my old bones.
I'll be fine. I'm Sakura of Eagle Squad. I feel no pain. Ow! What is wrong with you?
Cook should know what to do with this.
And that was a fight. Reminds me of my younger squad years.
You mean before you became a seed spitter in Plainsong? I'll never understand why veterans agree to do it.
Seeds are pretty tasty.
I guess the farmer hasn't lost all his fighting spirit. Supplies should be up there. Taller than I thought.
What's a deadly climb to Eagle Squad?
What are you trying to say, old man?
Enough. I'm a good climber. I'll grab the supplies.
Come. Let's see if any of these machines have parts we can strip. Maybe I'll show you a thing or two.
What could a farmer possibly know about salvage?
Only decades of experience compared to your very brief existence.
Okay. Gotta find a way into the ruins. Some kind of basement. Gotta find a way up. Okay, the supply cache should be at the top of the tower, but how to get up there? Vines from a metal flower. It doesn't look like it's blocking the way up, though. There's a crate in that room.
be useful if I can get it out. That platform up there doesn't look very stable. Shooting those ropes might make it fall. Like Sakura supplies. These are the supplies? Won't last them very long.
that kid alone for a second. Jackson's a corner in trouble. I gotta catch up to them. And take down those machines. Locked. Not getting in that way.
Let's check around the side.
I better check on Jackson Sakura. This isn't the cache I came to find.
Well fought, Eagle. Though I would have preferred if you hadn't taunted that thing. What did you find?
Practically nothing. Sakura, there's Maybe a day's worth of food here and some rotting medicinal herbs.
It was supposed to be more. Enough for...
It was never your intention to go home, was it?
What do you mean?
A blind Tanakh can't fight. And if you can't fight...
The Tanakh will kill Korra from being blind?
He'll face a trial against the machine.
They say it's more dignified that way. But it's still a death sentence.
So you were gonna use the extra supplies to live in the wilds?
I thought it would be enough to get us started.
Can't they stay in Plainsong?
Plainsong has too many mouths to feed. The chorus would never allow it.
We should get back.
I'll take this young sprout back. Meet us at the cave when you can.
Shotgun against that machine. I can do about those vines for now. This isn't the cache I came to find.
supposed to tell them that I failed?
Speak the truth. Plain and simple. Aloy, we were just about to head in. So what will you tell them?
That we'll have to make do. Survive in the wilds without the supplies.
That will be a hard life.
Better than letting Corey be killed if we go back.
There must be another way.
I don't see one.
So, we're all stocked up then?
The cache was empty. But we'll be all right without them.
I can't let you starve out here. Just leave me.
No!
Jax, you said Plainsong has too many mouths to feed to take them all in, but what about just—
I am not leaving my brother behind!
He'll be safe in Plainsong, and the rest of you can head home. It's the only real solution you've got.
The chorus won't like it. But if I vouch for the boy, share my rations with him, I could convince them. I will do so if Korra wishes.
No! You're not taking him!
Sakura, I think this is the best option. I'm a burden to you out here. This is what I want. Let me go with him.
Permission granted. But brother, this is not the end for us. I will visit you in Plainsong, and no Utaru or Tanakh can stop me.
They will be foolish to try. I'll stay and help them pack their gear, then take Korra back with me. You've shown strength and wisdom today. Rare combination. You have my thanks and theirs too, I'm sure. Take a short while, then we'll be on our way. Korra will be safe in Plainsong, I promise. Truth be told, my bones ache from all the fighting.
Thank you. those to attack me if I destroy them. frost ammo's not gonna do much. Find this in my stash later. Acid will eat right through that metal. Must be the machines that Gandalf and Rashad were talking about. Could stop one of its attacks if I break those. Thank you. But these ruins fall off into the water. Won't be able to dive too deep, though. I should take a look at the ruins under the water. See if I can find any clues. Something jammed in that console underwater, but I can't hold my breath long enough to yank it out. Underwater, but I can't hold my breath long enough to yank it out.
May your arrows find their mark. For poison.
I'll repair the data I have on plow horns before I can override them.
You're on for a tea ceremony, right? Having a good day?
May the sun shine upon you.
Children, all right?
Let me take a look at you, stranger. You're the outlander who stood against Regala and her rebels.
Only if it means we're good here.
Don't worry. I'm not here to drink your blood, or whatever you Easterners think we do. The slaughter at the embassy wasn't your fight, yet you stood by the Martians. As far as I'm concerned, you're no enemy of the Tanakh. But you are going to need help if you plan on surviving the clanlands. I hear and see many things as a scout. I could share them with you, aid you on your journey.
I'd be grateful.
Well then, choosing the right rations can be just as important to your chance of survival as choosing the right weapons. If you want food that'll save your life out in the wilds, go northwest to Salt Bite. The cook there, Pintala, she'll whip up a meal for anyone who needs it, to knock or not.
I'll make sure to pay her a visit if I'm out that way.
I've got nothing to report. Keep your eyes open out there, soldier.
can't get rid of the vines. Not yet, anyway. There'd be one here. I should find their leader. Put an end to this. Weak against shock.
Where do you say we check everything? So we check.
Tail's got some heavy gear. They must be in charge.
We need to strengthen defenses here.
Who's there?
Check them for tags. Unlock the tags. I'll have to figure out what to do with them later. Without a leader, the rebels should abandon this place. But I could always deal with them now. Either way, I'm done here.
Going down.
Post won't be causing any more trouble. Should hit it with frost ammo. Thank you.
again. Fit.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade. Right. Your loss.
Did you see those kids riding around on machines out west?
You mean rebels?
They didn't look like any rebels I've ever seen. I tried to follow them, but they were too fast.
I'll keep my eyes open. Sound like rebels. Maybe if I follow their tracks, I can find out where they're headed. I can probably use my focus to follow the tracks those riders left behind. Now and write them. From before, the ones who were racing. Wonder what they're up to.
You threw a rock in my face.
It's not like you can get any uglier.
Ha ha.
Hey, who are you?
Everyone, we got company.
riding machines, huh? Who taught you to do that?
Hey, squad! We got someone with a death wish here.
Whoa. Look at that hair. What? Someone get a little lost in the desert?
Hey, what's that thing the Easterners keep saying we do?
Oh, yeah. We all drink blood here, right? Maybe we should drink yours.
You can try.
Is that a challenge?
Cool your blaze, Josek. Don't think you want to test your luck with a soldier that took down Regala's champion. We have no business with you, Outlander. I think we all had our fun. Road's right over there.
Those machines used to be Regala's. But you don't look like holdouts to me. Who are you? How'd you get these mounts?
Around here, you want something, you race for it. You cross that finish line first, I'll answer any questions you have.
Aloy, you got a mount?
Race is full.
Actually, I think a spot just opened up.
All right. What are the rules?
Don't die.
This ought to be good.
Shut up, Pekka.
This way, fresh meat. Let's get you that mount. I see you carry a bow. Good. You'll need to use it if you want to win.
Against the other racers?
They will if you don't. We put everything on the line when we get on that track. Makes it worth something. You can test run the track if you want to. Just let me know when you're ready for the real thing.
I'll do a practice run.
If you think it'll help.
Thank you. I'm good to go.
Let's hit the track. Prize for winning the race. You earned it.
I think you owe me some answers.
Name's Atta. As for how we got these mounts, most of us here used to be rebels. Joined Regala's army thinking we'd get a chance to fight in a real war against the Karja. Instead, Regala slaughtered our own in cold blood, barren light. When we made it back to camp, we snuck out on our mounts and never looked back, been racing the clan lands ever since. Decided we were better off on our own. No rules, no chiefs. Just the speed of our mounts and the taste of blood.
Doesn't sound too bad, I guess. Where's your quiet friend? The one with the mask. He didn't join the race.
He gave up his spot so you could join. Probably for the best.
What makes you say that?
That one hasn't lost a single race. Thought you would have gotten your answers if he stuck around.
Maybe.
You know, Hax found a spot to set up a race at the farthest end of Lowland territory, right by the beach. Make your way there, maybe there'll be a spot waiting for you.
If I'm in the area, I'll think about it.
Hey, Lloyd, you here to join the race?
Thank you.
Anyone got some machine oil to spare? Max!
I think we have some left over. Let me look.